So that's Izumo's central palace. There's something calming about it.
Truly.
Yes, Izumo has long been known as the Kingdom of the Gods. It only makes sense that the center of its power would radiate peace. While all the other kingdoms quarrel, it maintains a neutral stance. I'm glad we made it here safely. Let's go find the Archduke.
I am Izana. Yes, the Izana!
Wait, where the hell are we? Why are we in the middle of the village? I mean, I'm pretty sure this is probably Zola again. It's always Zola. But why are we here? First heir to the divine bloodline, descendant of the gods, keeper of prophecies, and winner of best hair 5 or 6 times, I forget. So nice to finally meet you. I imagine your journey here was quite difficult. Time to kick back and relax. Izumo is a wonderful place. You could stay here forever.
Oh.
Thank you very much for such a warm greeting.
Well...
Oh, it's nothing. You know, I'm really glad you came. I rarely have company. I'm so excited, I hardly feel like myself. Yeah, it's Zola. I don't understand. Why is he being so informal? Is this how all major leaders of the world are meant to behave?
No.
They don't normally act this way. He's just a special case. Pardon me, Archduke. We actually came here to ask you some questions.
What?
Oh? What about? Ask away, my friends. If you've got any good gossip to share, I'd be ever so pleased to listen.
Well...
We were wondering if you could share what you know about the Seal of Flames.
Uh-huh.
The Seal of Flames? That sounds pretty boring to me. I don't bother remembering dull things. I see. Just when we thought we were going to catch a break, too.
Well.
Hey now, don't look so disappointed. I've prepared a feast for you inside. You should eat, drink, and be happy while there's still time to do so.
Wait.
Are you sure you don't know anything about the Seal of Flames? The fate of the world may hang in the balance. Grr, I said I've never heard of it.
Imposter!
Of course you haven't, you imposter. What? You're calling me an imposter after I've prepared a feast for all of you?
War and I go way back.
Don't be coy with me. It's plain to see you're hiding behind a magic illusion. Reveal yourself. Ah, Gunter, you're no fun at all. It's been a while, hasn't it? Zola, I knew it was you behind that magic. Gunter, who is this? This cretin is a Norian mage. He specializes in illusions and deception. But then, where's the real Archduke? I'm afraid it's off to jail for him. The clink, the slammer, the cooler. Oh, cooler. That reminds me. It's time to make use of King Garen's ice bomb. Everyone, fire! Fire the ice bomb. Wait, why does King Garen have an ice bomb? Why would he need an ice bomb? I don't get it. Wait. And why did they ice bomb the village instead of Corrin and the people? Okay. Making sense of this story is not a good idea. Get ready, everyone! Benched. Actually, hold on. Oh god, if I use you, how bad are you gonna be? What is the map anyway? Oh, you break through the ice? Holy crap, that's really annoying. Okay, the good thing about Zola is that he's using Nosferatu. Actually, I don't know if that's a good thing, but... At least he doesn't have a stupid crit tome anymore, the Mjolnir. Mozu is a must. Why do I only get 6 units? That's so irritating. Hana, because I actually need her to be useful later. Not now. Okay, whatever. I'm just gonna do this then. I think at some point I'll be able to use her. And there's always the Armor Slayer. The good thing about sword users is that they get a lot of options early game. Armor Slayer and the Worm Slayer can be used the last hit really well. Kaze is just overall the better unit, especially with Poison Strike. It's kind of weird. You can't use Hayato after getting him. It's really strange. Yeah, it's an ice map. Apparently there's this super powerful ice bomb that can be used to freeze an entire village. But they'd rather freeze the village instead of my army. Makes a lot of sense. I'm guessing the enemies are in the ice, because it makes no sense for there to be no enemies.
Oh my!
It's incredible, they've done something to encase the entire town and village, in ice. The entire village, yeah. We'll have to break through it! If the enemy is probably using this ice as cover, be careful. Wait, this is a seize map? What the hell am I seizing? Seizing planes, nice. I should probably use my weaker units to attack first, so I'll use Kaze first. Does it matter which one I attack? Wait, I have to break it like this? Oh my god, that's so irritating if it's like one at a time. Oh, you break whole sections off. Okay, that's not as bad then. Yeah, this is gonna be kind of like the fog thing, you can't see the enemies. This is gonna be another slow map, just like last map.
No need to worry.
What the hell? He had a mend on him. That's so weird. It was a cavalier with a mend on him. Is there an enemy inside there? Yeah, this is gonna be a slow map. Because I can't break the ice if I only have like two attackers left. On the off chance that I get ambushed, I'd probably die. Wow, this map is annoying. Yeah, like that. Two enemy units.
Allow me!
We need each other.
Fare thee well.
Wait, are they all carrying items? Oh my god. I was saying this in the previous map, you get way too many items in Revelation so far. It's like they're force-feeding you items to make the game easier. Which is actually really bad, because I don't want the game to be easier. What the? Oh, he used the elixir! Wow, he ate my elixir! I'm restarting. I'm not gonna let him eat the elixir. That's definitely not gonna happen. I probably shouldn't have attacked. Damn. The elixir is really expensive. It's like 800 gold or something. Oh, whoops. Okay, let's try this. Oh god. No, not like this! I really don't like this map already. Okay, I'm hoping for no Dragon Fang here.
Remain calm. This ends now!
Okay. Working crit.
Alright!
I mean, technically there was no Dragon Fang, so... Yeah, game listened. Damn, Felicia still deals zero damage. Well, that's one damage. Gets zero damage on that. He's still way too high level. It's really annoying. My elixir, gimme.
Did I get stronger? I'll do my best. Too slow!
Thank you.
Wait, I just realized something. Who is Kaze marrying? What was my plan for Kaze? Oh wow, did I not marry him with anyone? Or put him with anyone? Holy crap, he's not getting married! Okay, maybe I need to reevaluate the plan. Yeah, something's gotta change, I guess. Because Kaze should get married. It'd be weird if he didn't. I do plan on using him. Interesting. I don't know why I didn't plan for Kaze getting married. Doesn't make any sense. Energy drop. It's a good item for Kaze.
We won't give up. This is my chance.
Who's even left? Perry?
We can do this.
I think it's only Perry left. I'm gonna have to change it around.
You'll be alright.
I'm impressed.
Wonder if I should hard seal him now. If I do that, he has to use a bronze sword. Don't have one at the moment. The faster I hard seal, the faster he gets good abilities. rather, the faster he gets not bad abilities when he class changes. So the point of doing it early is to make it so when he's second class, he doesn't waste levels getting bad skills.
Leave it to me. I'm here for you.
Yeah, like I said, I don't know what's up with Revelation. They just like to feed you items. It makes the game so much easier when they do this. I don't think it's a good idea. You already get two armories and two staff shops. As if that wasn't enough, you get a ton of money with garbage items, stat boosters, like a whole bunch of things that make the game a lot easier. I think they're gonna drop me a bronze sword, but I do want to change him into a samurai soon. She's almost at rank D.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Mikaze and Azura should get married. It's gonna be Azura with Saizo, because I want to turn into a ninja. You still get ninja from that pairing. Might be a better pairing, actually. Because Midori is actually really slow, with Azura she's probably a lot faster. Whereas Gaius is just fast, always. So the pairing is kind of relevant. Midori's also a backline unit, whereas Gaius kind of goes up a bit more. Backline unit is good with Azura's skills. Yeah, I don't know, it's hard to say. Understand why this map is the way it is. It's probably designed so that you get some experience on certain characters. So using Hana on this map would have been okay. Having double healer is excessive. So if I do die for any reason, I'll just remove a healer. Sakura gets rally luck next turn, next level. It's not useful yet, but it will be useful in the future. Okay, so I'm probably just gonna leave this and go down now. Let's get more items. Is that a mistake? Okay, good. Nothing's there. Scary. What other female units are there anyway? Felicia with Kaze, would that work? Tonebreaker is actually not bad. Because Midori uses bows primarily. I doubt I'm gonna use her though. Because you don't get many characters in this path. I say that because you get double royals. It's too much noble blood. Somebody even mentioned the other day that Elise was not very good in Revelation. I find that hard to believe, because she's really good in Conquest. But yeah, we'll have to see. Sakura so far is doing pretty well, because she's actually here. Like, that's one of the most relevant points. If the character doesn't have any levels where they get experience, then chances are they're not very good. Like, the most extreme example would be if you get a character with 100% growth in every stat on the final chapter. Chances are that character's still gonna be garbage, because it doesn't matter anymore.
Fare thee well.
Oh, I guess also the other problem is I have both Felicia and Sakura already. So if I get Elise, then what happens? Because Elise isn't any better than these two as a healer. Their magic is about the same in the early game. Elise definitely gets more magic in the late game, though. Because Sakura's hybrid. Oh my god! It's a knight! Oh god, that's awkward. That is so random. The purpose of the map is just to give you items and experience. If I die for any reason, I'm probably gonna remove Felicia. Remove Felicia and then put in Hana, and then give him a bronze sword. Class change him into samurai. But at the rate this is going, I don't think I'm gonna have to restart. It's very slow, but I don't think anything's gonna happen. Unless there's like a random berserker in the middle or something. Breach roll. Berserker or a hero or something stupid. I doubt the game would do that. Gotta admit, the map is innovative. It's just kind of annoying.
Remain calm.
Be careful.
Probably dead end. Scared for nothing. Oh, that's a problem. I can't kill both of them. HP's good. Ozu doesn't have high HP growth, so whenever she gets HP, it's good. Wow, he almost gets one shot. Terrible growth for Kaze. A good growth for him would be strength. Oh hey, there is a unit right there.
Here we go. It's my turn.
It ends here.
Of shall we? I'm over here!
Ooh, another heart seal. Nice.
We won't lose.
Your battle has ended.
Yeah, this entire map, I don't like it, because it just feeds you items. It doesn't even seem like Lunatic if it does that. Because if you use all, let's say you use all the stat boosts, then you gain like a ton of stats. Plus you have good items now. So you have a bunch of new items, new iron weapons, heart seal, a bunch of healing items. It just doesn't feel as challenging if this happens. Too much casual emblem. Oh, that's a problem.
Everything will be all right.
Oh, whoops, wrong weapon.
This ends now.
Okay, that was worth. Got the cool animation. See, that's 900 gold. That's 500 gold. This is 600. This is a, what, 10,000 gold? This map is just a gold mine.
Here I am. You won't stop me! Thank you.
Shiro's growth has been pretty bad. I know it seems weird to say that because she just got like a ton of stats, but HP and defense is what you want. Unfortunately, Lunatic is seated, so the stat growths are pretty set. Let's just hope they get changed up a bit after a few more levels. As in the trend, not the stats, because the stats can't change. On the previous map, I made a comment about how the enemy units were so much stronger than mine, and it felt like it was actually a challenge. So enemy units would like nearly double attack you. They do double attack you if you're not playing like a ninja, or not using a ninja or something. And it actually felt like Lunatic, because your units were so damn weak. But when you have a map like this, where you just slowly grind through it, it removes that challenge, the Lunatic challenge. So because of all the levels I got, look at Kaze's level now. It's got two full levels, I'm not even complete the map yet. Mozu got two levels, not even done the map. It's insane. Experience is insane. Oh, what the? It's a wall. Uh-oh. I felt like Conquest choked away my money. That's why it was challenging. But already Revelation is not doing that. It's like the opposite. It's feeding me money. It's feeding me money and experience. That was another thing. On Conquest, if you didn't use Corrin with Dragonstone, you were pretty much screwed. Niles, Odin. Odin especially was really bad early game. Nyx was pretty bad. Kaze was pretty bad. Though you don't get Kaze until like mid game. What else did you get? Oh, Arthur and Effie. Effie was good, but Arthur was bad. So you had all these characters that are just really terrible. And you were forced to get experience on Corrin. So experience in general was not very easy to get. Because you were forced to give it to 1% primarily. If you didn't do that, you just lose. So yeah, this is feeling a little more like Birthright than anything else. I'm hoping it actually gets harder though. Birthright was decently difficult in terms of stats. Oh, this could actually be a difficult part. It's a choke point. We can't put all the units through. I'll have to wait then. Statistically, Birthright units were not like that much off from Conquest. But they had no skills. And their AI sucked. That's what made it easy. Through. Holy crap, that scared me. I thought I screwed up. Because I can't tank all three of them. They're actually really strong. Dark mages deal a lot of damage because I have low resistance. Wow, if I had to restart there, that would be really bad. What? Okay, speaking of really bad... Huh. Okay, that's just mean. What the hell? Oh my god, that is so bad. This is just troll as hell, it's not even difficult. I'm just gonna put a random unit with a crit tome in the middle here. Right before the boss, after you break all the ice. So I spent 37 turns, and now there's a chance I die. Amazing. That is so amazing. 7 times 4, it's a killer weapon, so it's 4 times instead of 3 times. So it's 28 damage, because I dies. Holy crap, are you serious? Fifteen resistance. 6 times 4 is 24 damage. So Felicia has to do it. Oh my god, it's so troll. 24 damage taken if I get crit. That's just stupid.
You've got this. I can help you.
This is how not to design your game. Putting a random crit guy in the middle, it's so troll. And putting him at the end of a really slow map. God damn it. Okay, well the good thing is, it doesn't break the ice on the top. Worst case scenario would have been, put the crit tome guy there and then let these guys loose. Once you break the ice here. Fortunately, they have a heart. They have a soul. They're not entirely evil. Actually, this is beneficial because... Let's see. Kaze takes 10 damage from each. So he doesn't die, no matter what. He has weapon triangle advantage, plus he has damage reduction from 2 units. So I can actually eliminate the mages immediately. They don't have anything that's a big threat. No skills, no crits. Just raw damage. 9 defense. And 5 speed. So with the steel dagger, I deal 12 damage times 2. It's exactly lethal. I mean, even if it isn't, then... Korin can use his assist with the crit. So this should eliminate the 2 mages.
Trust me. You're too
slow. Oh, whoops! I actually miscalculated the damage.
That was a good fight.
It's only 11. Okay, well, it's still lethal. It's fine.
Be careful. Look me in the eyes.
We have won.
Okay, so that makes the gauntlet a little more easier once you get to it. Let's continue with the ice picking. Yay, so fun. Oh, what the? Hitting this one breaks this thing over here? What? Alright, fine, whatever. I'll just kill this guy.
You'll be alright.
Let me try!
What do you know?
Resident Sleeper.
That was a good fight.
Thank you.
Alright, we're almost done. Zelda's Nosferatu could be annoying. But, oh god, there's two. Do you crit too? No, you don't. And they're giving me more money. Okay, nice. Of course I need more money. It's not like I don't get more money. Get enough money. As is. What is Felicia holding? Oh, it's a candle. Oh, I see. Nice weapon.
I am at your service. Remain calm.
Wow, Kazuya's turning out to be pretty bad right now. He's only at 12 strength, level 13. I mean, that's pretty typical for him. It's not ideal, but it's typical. That's why I've been wanting to use Saizo this entire time. Because my Saizo on Birthright was really good. He capped out like 3 stats, and one of them was almost capped. Fourth stat was almost capped. It's a no grind run as well. So he does it pretty trivially, getting all the stats up. Plus he's a hybrid character. Not in a bad way, not like Sakura hybrid. He actually gets really high stats and like everything. Whereas Sakura's really balanced and everything. Alright, this is 18 plus 7, potentially plus 28. Could just end the map right here. You can't possibly defeat me, famous last words.
I make my own fate.
Yep.
No more hiding.
Master Seal is nice, but nobody is level 20 yet. Corrin gets like one experience for everything. 45 turns.
It's over.
We've won. You can't escape now, Zola. Tell us where the Archduke is. You really think it'd be that easy? What a naive little boy you are. I always have an escape plan. What are you? Oh, look at me and my adorable hostage.
Big brother!
Corrin!
Sakura!
Let her go, Zola. Are you really going to stoop this low? Do the honorable thing. Phew, to your honor, I'd rather win than be honorable. After all, the winner is the one who writes the history books. Now, put down your weapons. If you don't, the girl... He dies to Leo in, like, every single storyline. Every single path. Oh, wow, he actually died. Okay. That magic...
Contemptible fool!
You were the lowest of the low, Zola. Hiding behind hostages, you disgraced the entire Norian army.
Huh?
I knew it. It was you, Leo. Thank you for saving Sakura.
Leo.
Will you join us? We could use your aid in the battles ahead. I don't plan to fight with Nor. I've learned of the dire truth.
What?
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
After I refused to side with Hoshido or Nor, I learned that King Garen, he's being manipulated by someone. What? How do you know this?
Listen.
Carefully. He didn't want to start this war with Hoshido. He's being controlled by our real enemy, someone hiding from behind the scenes. This invisible foe is who we should really be after.
I see.
Well then, tell me who is pulling the strings. Name the manipulator.
I'm so sorry.
Leo, I can't say who it is. Unsurprising. I don't know why I wasted time listening to your ramblings.
Leo!
Please, wait. I can't say anything now, but...
Traitor.
You're a traitor. I don't want to hear your excuses. What? You still don't believe that I have the best intentions?
Excuse me.
Let me make this as clear as I can. You've abandoned our family, and I have extended you the same courtesy. I no longer think of you as my brother. Got it? I only came here to clean up that vile mage. You and I will settle our differences some other time. Corrin!
No.
Don't worry, Azura. I'm fine. I don't think he was aiming at me. The door to that banquet hall has seen better days, though.
What are you waiting for?
Go on, Corrin. The real Archduke should be inside. Along with the pathetic Hoshidan Prince Takumi.
Huh?
What? Do you mean... Wait, Leo. Leo.
Big brother!
Corrin, let's say each other's names over and over again. The banquet hall is filled with people. They've all been tied up.
What was that?
You can't be serious.
Ah, here we go.
You're here, you finally come to rescue me. Thank you so much, you really saved my life. I'm absolutely starving. My tummy has been rumbling for hours.
Oh.
Are you truly the Archduke of Izumo?
Yeah.
Why yes, that's me. Archduke Izana, first heir to the royal, divine bloodline, descend... Sorry, Archduke, but we've kind of already heard this. Even the hair part?
Yes.
Aw. He's even more informal than the imposter.
Ooh.
The fair princess Sakura, I believe your brother is around here somewhere. He was left in a situation similar to my own. I can only imagine how hungry he is now.
What?
Takumi really is here? Takumi, I'm so glad you're safe. Sakura? And Korin and Azura, what are you all doing here? Well, I decided that I would fight alongside Korin.
What?
Sakura, you've turned against Hoshido as well? Ryoma's gonna be devastated.
No.
I haven't. Neither has Korin. No one here has, actually. None of us plan to fight against Hoshido. Korin says there is something much worse than Nora's aggression going on. He can't explain, but I trust him. Takumi, please. Trust him too.
Takumi.
Ah. You'll have to excuse me if I don't find this flimsy explanation acceptable. Sakura may believe your story. I don't. I see. No. Ah, this won't do. This won't do at all. You've got it wrong, Prince Takumi.
Huh?
What are you talking about? I'm not going to go into all the little details, but basically, join Korin. Yeah, listen to Izana. That's what the gods are telling me. Just got some prophetic stuff from them.
What?
Something prophetic? I can't believe that important prophecies just happen all of a sudden like that.
Hmm.
Hey, who's the keeper of prophecies here, you or me? They come as they come. Would you really ignore directions sent down from the gods? You know, you said that, but... How can I choose to side with someone who won't side with his homeland? Of course, I'm grateful they saved us, but I just can't trust Korin. Jeez, you're one tough nut to crack. What am I supposed to do with you? I don't like breaking out the big bows, but if a little extra prophesizing is needed, well, Prince Takumi, that's just what you'll get. Is that a bug on the ground? Ahem. Everything is not yet seen. The truth is far and hidden low. The one upon the water surface. He who knows all is the true foe.
Phew.
There you go. Good prophecy. I have no idea what you just said. The gods really want to speak with you, Prince Takumi. Prince Korin is not your enemy. Then who is? What was Sakura saying a moment ago? That Korin knows something about our supposed enemy.
Yeah.
I can't explain it all now, but what Archduke Izana says is true. We came to Izumo hoping to find a way to defeat our mystery enemy.
Oh!
That's right. You were going to ask me about the Seal of Flames. I'm sorry, but I don't know a thing about it. How could you possibly know what we were going to ask about?
Well...
premonitions, prophecies. Haven't you been paying attention? Even though I can't help you with the Seal of Flames, my family does have a saying that's been passed down for generations. We will show he who shuns the light and the dark another way. So there you have it.
What do you mean?
Is Korin the one who shuns the light and the dark? I think so. Thus, I need to show you a new path. If you'll excuse me, I'll go hold a little ceremony and ask an ancient god for help.
Huh?
Right now?
Yep.
Fortune favors the bold. Strike while the iron's hot. Carpe whatever. I want to get this little ceremony over with, in any case. Ancient gods aren't exactly easy on the eyes. Those are bugs on the ground, right? Damn, this place is filthy. I hope he returns with some sort of helpful clue to all this.
Yeah.
I'm sure things will work out. Let's have faith and wait here for him. Yeah, those are bugs on the ground. This place is disgusting. Sorry to have kept you waiting. Archduke, what's wrong? You look exhausted.
Hey!
I had a chat with an ancient god, but even I don't understand it. It's so short, too. Go meet the dragon.
Huh?
A dragon?
Uh-huh.
I'm sure you'll figure it out eventually. I really, really hope you do, too. After all, I think I may... ow, ow, ow. Yep. Definitely gave my life for the message. Wait, what? You're dying? How did this happen? Well, the ceremony I performed always requires something in return. Every message has a price, and the cost of this one was my life. That's so weird. I'd really like it if a bard wrote a nice song about my noble sacrifice. Oh, Prince Takumi, I know I asked you before, but make sure you help out Korin, okay?
No.
But I... What? You're still not willing? I'm dying here, and you're still unsure? Listen, if you don't go, I'll come back as a ghost and haunt you. All the time. Boo. Archduke. Well, I said what I needed to say. Bye-bye. So he just dies randomly?
Why?
Who's gonna take care of his bugs? Why didn't he tell us this would cost him his life? Why? Oh, Izana. Giving up his life for the good of everyone. He was an admirable man. Admirable. There we go.
I'm so sorry.
This is my fault. If I hadn't picked this path, the Archduke wouldn't have died like this. He always says stuff like this. If I didn't choose this path, if I chose Conquest or Birthright, he'd be alive. It's like he knows. I didn't realize the cost of my goal. That's right. As I believe it to be.
Please.
You must keep believing in it. Don't waste the sacrifice.
Takumi, listen.
I'm gonna help you accomplish your mission. I'll fight with you. After all, it was the Archduke's dying wish. That's so random. Why does he just die randomly? So now he's joining. If I recall correctly, he was really skeptical of Korin for quite a few chapters, even in Birthright. Right? Well, I guess he didn't join immediately, that's why. So, I'm coming along, brother. Thank you, Takumi, I won't let you down. Well, if Lord Takumi is going, I guess we'll have to go too.
Right.
Yes, finally. It's time to pair him up with Overo. I'd sooner die than be separated from Lord Takumi.
Huh?
And you are...
All right.
The name's Hinata, also known as You're Instantly Benched. I'm one of Lord Takumi's retainers. I'm skilled with a katana, not really. If I do say so myself, okay. You'll like having me in a fight. No, I won't.
Yes.
My name is Oboro. Like Hinata, I am a retainer to Lord Takumi. If at all possible, I'd rather not interact with the Norians. But if we are to be allies, then I will do my best to cooperate. For Takumi's sake.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm glad to have you with us. That's three more valuable allies. Thank you, Archduke Izana. This is all thanks to you. I promise to never forget the sacrifice you made for us. Wait, we don't have that many Norians, huh?